It's very park-like. I'll have to read the sign back there on my photos. And all this beauty is surrounded by terrible pine forest logging and desecration. And it's a bit of a drive in through it all, and a stony road, but it's all right. It's as good as this track. And it's a very nice little rainforest, although somewhat dry today. Oh, they didn't tell me it was so amazing.
Yeah.
What's it into? Well,
it's in here, it's
waterfall,
one of the best examples of in Tasmania.
There's a sea note.
All right, I'll see you back at lunch.
Right.
That's the steps coming down over there. Found it all. A bush ranger, no doubt. The usual graffiti nuts. Looks like a fig tree growing up the old fern here. An amazing place to discover some good handiwork by some local convicts on the stairs and the walk.
This is the pleasant drive going out.
Tia Bridge.
No.
How deep is it?
What does it say?
You take the photograph of the bill as well.
What does it say, Bill? There's no suggestion about how deep it is. It's very noisy. They probably don't know.
Leatherwood petals fluttering down from the trees. There's a felled one. I don't think we've been here before, actually. I'll have to check our 2005 video. Just staring up at this huge tree that the road goes around, and someone's climbed up there. If I can find the branch, there's a few ends, smooth flush ends, that people have pruned.
Close that thing.
Must have been threatening to drop off.
Yeah.
And this one's been pruned up there, so someone's shot a bow up. The carrier a belay and climbed it with their chainsaw.
Over in the other
trees, yeah, Karawong. There's a creek coming in from the left. There's the old bridge. It's collapsing. Could be a bridge or just a tunnel. Could be a platypus down here. We might be a bit lucky to see a platypus down there. What you need is a beer. You just sit there like that chap and wait for an hour. Well, back at the River Breeze, had dinner and a red, chatted for an hour with these travelling people who do house sits, and now we'll hang out some washing somewhere, go to bed. Just packing up, I head off to George Burney along the rugged coast, or bypass Burney. Just getting a description of Des's setup here, and his V8 Troopy, not Troopy, Ute, and his fabulous van setup. Yeah, Quantum. Yeah, and up there's the off-road sign, behind that is the firewood rack, which is great. Yeah. there, stop and put your firewood in there. And there's your black water storage down there with a macerator. That's brilliant. Pump it out when you want to.
And round the other side here is our pump out.
And there's all these cupboards in the back of the truck.
Put your hose to that, turn the tap, and it just pumps directly to the waste.
Oh, okay. We've got some old carpet on our roof, yeah, and we've got those, but...
And we just sort of stick things in.
Yeah, ours is fading. Ours is losing it. This is Port Latta. Little shacks on
it. Crayfish Creek.
Crayfish Creek. Yep. As you can see, let's have lunch and check on a water leak from our water tank. Flathead fillet.
No, it's the head and
sunglasses. That's without the sunglasses. Looks like a cub camper wanderer. This is all the free camping along the edge of the beach. What's it called? Boat Harbour. Self-contained campers. I would have thought the local council would have clamped down on this. This is the end of the road. Can't see what I'm looking at. Too many bright lights reflecting. That's one way up back towards the Rocky Cape. Another shack at the end of Boat Harbour. This is the end of the subdivision. Private property. The entrance to the walkway into Boat Harbour. is discovering Wynyard.
Allowing him to study in Melbourne, Karen Percy reports.
25-year-old Yusuke Kano was in Bourke Street on January the 20th, 2017. Through WorkSafe and Victoria Police are in...
He's filling up the boat with diesel.
Caravan park. More houses and things along here. Across the road from the beach, railway line. The trains go past a couple of times a day. Camping.
There's a bus.
Wow. There's a biggie. Two push outsides.
There's three. There's one.
There's the beach.
They're all having a good time. There's another one up ahead.
Yeah. Another one over the other side.
Penguin Caravan Park again, same spot, just about, next to the big red one. Hi!
Hi!
There's our friendly neighbours. Thank you. peaceful caravan park. The morning train passes our caravan park in Penguin. There's the flat cars going past now. And there's the radios full of reports on bushfires, which are pretty desperate down the southeast. Huronville's under threat. Could threaten snug all across that area. It's really bad. I posted some photos of the newspaper article from the Mercury on Flickr. Lookout signs. Got up to a water tank. A big place down there. Right. Spread. It's four units.
A couple of years ago, that was full underwater, as you'd have probably known.
Everybody here. Everybody here is in that little bus. Nice new development. Oh, okay. Newport, oh, the fourth. So the fourth valley is a bit of a. Take a photograph of them all.
Good.
It's a guided tour. They're eating local cherries and having lunch, I think. They're all in the little bus. Well, you can see my panorama on Flickr a little bit later. That's the valley, the fourth valley.